Hey kids, it's David. I'm back again, not by popular demand, but today I'm a magician and we're going to be talking about something really important again from the Bible. And what we're going to do, I've brought my special red box here to help me out and we're going to do a magic trick for you. We're going to do that with some Lego as well and we're going to build this race car. Now, did you know that we are not just randomly put together and have no purpose in life? But we are designed by a creator. And that's why I've got Creator Lego. Because if you just grab some pieces together from the Lego and just put them together very randomly, do you know what? It just doesn't seem to look like the picture on the front, does it? And we're sort of left going, that's a bit weird. It just doesn't make sense. But if you see this Lego, it comes with instructions to design our race car. So, what we're going to do is we're going to get my red box. And as you can see, I thought it was empty. I've been looking for that, $10. Woohoo! As you can see, it's empty. And what we're going to do is we're going to pour all our Lego into the box. That's all in there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to shake it around, shake it around, shake it around, shake it around. And now get the magic wand. And of course, we have to say, kids are cool. Let's see what we've got. And if you look in there, ta-da! We have our very special race car. Woohoo! Fantastic. All right, stop the applause at home. Stop the applause. It's just a race car. I know, I know. How did he do that? I'll keep that to myself. I get that. Just like the Lego needed a designer, instructions, and a creator, let's see what the Bible says about us. If we turn to Genesis, the very first book of the Bible, in the very first chapter, in verse 27, it says, "So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them." Let's not think we're just random objects with no purpose in life, but we are created in God's image. And each one of us are special in his sight. And we're all given purpose and put here for a reason to worship our Creator and to serve him and live for him. If you don't know your Creator, God, if you don't know Jesus, who God sent to this earth to die on the cross for your sins and my sins, so we can have a relationship with him, then now's the time to start thinking about it. Do you know God thinks you are worth it, that he did send Jesus to die on the cross for you, that you can have eternal life? John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Let's pray. Father, we just thank you so much that you loved us so much that you would send Jesus to come to earth and die on the cross for us. We just pray for every child, every parent, every grandparent watching today, that they will turn from their sin and turn to Jesus, and that they will have eternal life through him. We just thank you for the truth found in the Bible about us being created for purpose. And we thank you that we are created special. We do this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks, kids. We'll see you next time.